可以开始了。
Om Gyana Tamarandasya Gyananjana Shalakaya Chakshur Militam Yena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha Nama Om Vishnu Padaya Krishna Pristaya Bhutale Srimati Bhaktivedanta Swaminiti Namine Namaste Sarasati Devi Kauravani Precharine Nirvisesha Shunyavadi
Pascharine
Vanchakaupatarubhyascha Kripa Sindhu Bhaevacha Patitanam Pavanebhyo Vaishnavibhyo Namo Namaha Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhar Shri Vasade Gaur Bhaktavinda Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare Hare. So we're hearing about the pastimes of Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu as they're described in the Madhya Lila of the Chaitanya Charitamrita. So Lord Chaitanya had gone to visit South India for some time, but when he came back, then the king of Orissa, the Maharaja Prataparudra, was very anxious. He wanted to meet Lord Chaitanya. So the king wrote a letter to the Bhattacharya, telling him, or asking him, begging him to help him to get to meet Lord Chaitanya. But the Bhattacharya wrote back and told the king that Lord Chaitanya hadn't given his permission for him to meet him. So then the king wrote again, and he begged the Bhattacharya. He said, please get the support of all the devotees who are connected with Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, and beg them that they should help me to get to meet the king.
然后呢，国王又给巴达查尔又写了回信，他说呢，求你了，求你获得所有的Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu的同游的支持，然后得以使他能够有机会见到Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu。If
they will all support me, then they can help me to get the mercy of Lord Chaitanya.
如果他们要是能支持我的话呢，那么他们就都能够帮助我获得Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu的仁慈。
By the mercy of all the devotees, I can get the mercy of Lord Chaitanya. But without his mercy, then being the king has no meaning. I don't want to be the king anymore. If Lord Chaitanya is not going to give me any mercy, then I will give up my kingdom. And I would just become a beggar, and I'll beg from door to door. So the Bhattacharya, when he got that letter, he was quite worried, and he went to see all the devotees of Lord Chaitanya. And he took the letter with him, and he showed that letter to all the devotees and told them about the king's desire.
所以呢, 他就把这封信给所有的这些同游们看了,
So when all the devotees heard the letter, when they read the letter, they were amazed to hear about the king, how he had so much devotion for Lord Chaitanya. But at the same time, the devotees said that Lord Chaitanya will never agree to meet the king. And if we ask him, if we tell him to do it, he will feel very bad. He won't feel happy at all.
但是所有的奉献者都说呢，主持丹尼玛巴布是不可能答应见国王的。如果我们要是向他求这个情的话呢，那他肯定内心觉得非常的糟糕，他肯定不会觉得开心的。
So the Bhattacharya said, "Well, we can go to see Lord Chaitanya, but we will not ask him to meet the king. We will just simply tell him about the good behavior of the king."
然后巴达查尔就对这些朋友们说，说咱们去见主产丹尼，但是呢，咱们不跟他说，国王想见他的这件事儿，咱们只跟他说这国王的这些非常的优秀的品质、优良的举止。So
they all went to where the place where Lord Chaitanya was living, and when they got there, they didn't know what to say. They couldn't think what to say or how to begin.
然后呢，他们就来到了水产丹尼玛巴布的住处。可是当他们来这儿之后呢，他们不知道该怎么说，他们不知道从何说起。And
Lord Chaitanya said to them, he said, "Why have you all come here? I see you want to say something, but you're not saying anything. What's the problem?"
然后主产丹尼玛巴布就问他们，你为什么来这儿呢？我想你们来这儿肯定是想跟我说什么，可是你们现在又什么都不说，到底是什么问题，出了什么事儿？Then
Lord Nityananda said, "We want to tell you something, but we cannot stay without speaking, but we're still afraid to speak. We're afraid to tell you what we want to tell you."
然后呢，Sri Nityananda Prabhu就对主产丹尼玛巴布说，我们的确是有些事情想跟您讲，但是呢，我们这会儿又跟您说不出来，我们对于我们想跟您说的这话呢，有点害怕。
So Lord Nityananda told Lord Chaitanya, he said, "The problem is the king of Orissa is going to become a beggar unless he gets to meet you." He doesn't want to enjoy the kingdom if he cannot get the mercy of your lotus feet.
他如果要是得不到您的莲花族的仁慈的话，他就不想再享受他这王国了。He
wants to be able to have your association. He would like to take your lotus feet and put them on his heart.
他特别的希望能够得到您的联谊，他希望把您的莲花族搂在他的怀里。So
when Lord Chaitanya heard all of this, and his heart became a little more softer, he didn't feel so hard.
那么当时陈丹尼玛巴布听到这些话之后呢，他的这个心就变得越来越柔软了，他不像之前那么硬了。But
he decided that he should speak something hard, even though he didn't feel hard in the heart. He decided better that he speaks something hard to help the devotees to understand.
但是呢，虽然说他内心已经没有那么硬了，可是他觉得呢，他还得说点硬话。他只有说这个硬话，才能帮着这些奉献者明白到底是怎么回事儿。So
Lord Chaitanya says, "I think you all want to take me to go and see the king."
然后主持人妈妈说，我想你们大家呢，可能都是想把我拉去见这位国王。Actually,
the king should come to see Lord Chaitanya, but he said, "It seems like you all want me to go and see the king."
但事实上呢，国王应该来看望Sri Chaitanya, 但现在看起来好像你们都想让我去见这位国王。So
Lord Chaitanya said, If I go and meet the king, then everybody will blaspheme me. They will all say that just see, he's a sannyasi, and he's gone to see a king, a materialistic person.
然后释迦牟尼佛就说，如果我要是去见这位国王的话，那么所有的人都会辱骂我，就会说，你看，他是一个散亚西，可是他现在呢，他要去见一位国王了。
And Lord Chaitanya said, ordinary people say that, but Damodar, this devotee Damodar Pandit, he will chastise me, Lord Chaitanya said.
然后释迦牟尼佛说，这个普通的人会这么说。 而且呢 ，Damodar Pandit， 他也会斥责我的。
And then Lord Chaitanya said, "I won't meet the king at the request of all the devotees. I won't meet the king at all your request, but I will do so if Damodar gives his permission."
然后释迦牟尼佛就说呢，我不会因为你们要求我见这位国王，我就去见这位国王。但是呢。如果要是达摩达尔他允许我去见他的话，那我就去见他。
So we have to understand, Lord Chaitanya was a sannyasi. He was in the line of Shankaracharya, and they lived very strict lives as sannyasis.
那我们要知道，释迦牟尼佛巴布呢，他是一位 sannyasi， 而且呢，他是 Shankaracharya 这条传系上的 sannyasi。所以说呢，他们的生活是非常的严格的。
So if they see some fault, if they see some deviation from the proper behavior of the sannyas, then they will point it out and they will criticize the sannyasi.
所以如果他们要是看到这位 sannyasi 的生活有任何偏离或者不检点的地方的话，他们都会在这个人身上挑错，然后会斥责这位 sannyasi 的。
So Lord Chaitanya didn't want to be criticized because if he gets criticized, then it will not be good for his preaching. So Damodar Pandit, he loved Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, but he would always point out, if there was something he didn't like, he would always point it out to Lord Chaitanya and tell him that this is not good.
Damodar Pandit, 他一方面呢是非常的爱释迦牟尼佛马哈巴布的，但另外一方面呢就时刻的会指出这个释迦牟尼佛马哈巴布做的不对的地方，他就会跟他说这不好，那不对。
Damodar, he would say these things to Lord Chaitanya. He wouldn't consider how senior Lord Chaitanya is and how much more senior than he is. So he actually wasn't correct on him to point it out, but he would do it. He thought it's his duty to tell Lord Chaitanya that this is not good.
So the Damodar Pandit, he doesn't think Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's position is higher than his. He thinks Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is doing it wrong, he has to point it out, because he thinks this is his duty. Actually, he is not doing it right.
So Lord Chaitanya wanted to show that Damodar Pandit's behavior is foolish when he criticizes Lord Chaitanya.
So Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 呢想让 Damodar Pandit 看到，当他在指责 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 的时候，他这个做法是非常蠢的一种做法。
Yeah, Lord Chaitanya was giving a warning to Damodar Pandit that he should not criticize Lord Chaitanya.
所以呢，释迦牟尼佛巴布呢是想给达摩达尔潘迪的一个警告，来告诉他，他不应该去指责，不应该指责 Chaitanya。
Because Lord Chaitanya is the guide and he's the spiritual master of all the devotees who live there with him。
因为呢，其实释迦牟尼佛巴布呢，他是引导者，他是在那儿和他一起居住的所有的奉献者们的灵性导师。
So Damodar Pandit was also under the guidance of Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu.
所以说呢 ，Damodar Pandit 他其实也是在 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 的指导之下的。
So he was giving a warning to Damodar Pandit that he should not criticize him anymore.
所以呢 ，Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 他是在警告 Damodar Pandit。
So a devotee or a disciple, they shouldn't criticize the spiritual. They shouldn't criticize Krishna or Krishna's representative, the spiritual teacher.
所以说呢，作为一名奉献者，作为一名门徒，他就不要去指责 Krishna，以及不要指责 Krishna 的代表灵性导师。
So when Damodar Pandit heard this, then he said to Lord Chaitanya, he said, "You're the supreme personality of Godhead. You're fully independent. You know everything."
然后 Damodar Pandit 一听，听到 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 这么一说呢，他就说：“您是至尊人格首神，您是完全独立的，您控制着一切。”
I'm just an insignificant jiva, so I don't have any power to give direction to you. I cannot tell you what to do.
我不过是一个小小不言的 jiva， 我根本就不可能给您指导，我怎么能告诉您应该做什么呢？
And I'm sure by your own choice you will meet with the king. I'm sure it will happen.
而且我敢肯定，在您的意愿之下呢，您就会见到这位国王。在您的意愿之下，我敢肯定这是会发生的。
We can see the king is very attached to you, and you also feel some attachment and love for him.
我们可以看到这位国王非常的依附于您，而您呢，也对他有一些依附与爱。
So I'm sure the two of you will meet in the near future.
所以我敢肯定，在不久的将来，您二位一定会相见的。
Then he said to Lord Chaitanya, although you are the Supreme Lord and you are completely independent, still you depend on the love of your devotees.
然后他对 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 说，虽然说您是至尊主，虽然您是完全独立的，但是您依然还是依靠着您的奉献者对您的爱。
So that, then Lord Nityananda said, who is in the three worlds who can ask you to see the king? Nobody can tell you to go and see the king. But we know also it's the nature of an attached man. When someone's attached to something, he'll give up his life to get it.
那么我们也了解这种依恋之情。当某人对某件事情非常的依恋的时候，他会放弃他的生命，他会不惜放弃他的生命去获得这样东西。
Just like in Krishna Lila. One time the cowherd boys had come there to beg food for Krishna and Balaram. And the brahmana, their husbands, the men were doing a sacrifice.
就像有一次在 Krishna 的逍遥时光中，这些牧牛童们到正在做祭祀的婆罗门那里去向 Krishna 和 Balaram 讨要食物。
So the brahmanas, when they came there, the cowherd boys, they asked the brahmanas for some food, but the brahmanas just ignored them. They didn't give them any attention.
这些牧牛童们来到婆罗门的这里，然后呢，请求婆罗门给他们食物，但这些婆罗门呢，就完全不理这些牧牛童们，好像没有看见他们一样。
So then they went to the wives of the brahmanas, and when they went to the wives of the brahmanas, the wife of brahmanas, they were very eager to go and see Krishna and Balaram.
So, 呢，这些牧牛童们就去找这些婆罗门们的妻子。这些婆罗门的妻子们立刻呢，就非常的热切的想要去见 Krishna 和 Balaram.
But some of the wives of the brahmanas weren't able to go. And because they were not able to go, they just gave up, they died, they just gave up their bodies.
但是呢，有一些婆罗门的妻子当时就走不开，但就是因为他们走不开，所以他们当时就弃离了他们的躯体，他们就死了。
They couldn't, because just the thought of not being able to go and see Krishna, it caused so much pain that they died on the spot.
那么就是因为他们一想起他们不能够去见 Krishna。就这个想法让他们实在太痛苦了，所以呢，就让他们痛苦地死在了当时的那个现场。
So then Lord Nityananda made a suggestion to Lord Chaitanya.
然后呢，主尼提亚南达就向主柴坦尼亚马哈巴布做了一个示意。
And he said, there's a way by which you can meet the king, which will not cause any problem for you.
他说呢，有一种办法，可以使您见到国王，而且还不会给您招来任何的麻烦。
He said, what you can do is you can send one of your outer pieces of cloth to the king.
您可以做的事情呢，是把您的外衣，把您的一件外衣送去给这位国王。
And so the king, when he gets that piece of cloth, he will feel very happy and he will see you in that cloth.
那么，当国王见到了、得到了这件外衣的时候呢，他就会感到非常的开心，而且呢，他会通过见到了这件外衣而见到您。
So Lord Chaitanya said, yes, you're very learned persons, so whatever you decide, I agree.
所以去 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 说呢，说你们都是博学之士，所以你们所出的任何主意我都同意，我都接受。
So then Lord Chaitanya gave a piece of cloth, one of these uttariyas, you know, the outer cloth of the sannyasi, and they gave it to Govinda, and Govinda took it to give to the king.
所以呢，所以 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 呢就把这个 sannyasi 穿的这个外面的这块布巾儿就给了 Govinda， 然后就由 Govinda 把这块布巾儿送去给这位国王。
Actually, first Govinda gave it to Lord Nityananda, and then Lord Nityananda gave it to Bhattacharya, and then Bhattacharya he sent it to the king.
Okay, 实际上是这样的一个程序，就是 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 把这块布巾给了 Govinda 把它递给了 Juni Tiananda Prabhu，Juni Tiananda Prabhu 呢又把它给了 Bhattacharya， 然后是由 Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya 把它送去给了国王。
And when he got the cloth.Then the king began to worship it, just like he was worshipping Krishna directly.
那么，当这位国王得到了这块布巾之后呢，他就开始崇拜这块布巾，就好像他是直接在崇拜主 Krishna 一样。
Because that cloth was the Lord Chaitanya's piece of cloth, he'd been using it, he'd been wearing it, so it was one of a piece of his paraphernalia. It was not different from him.
因为这块布巾呢，一直是 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 所穿着的、所用着的，所以呢，就是他自己的一个贴身的一个物品，所以和 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 没有任何的区别。
Just like any pieces of clothing, or the bedding, or the slippers, everything which is used for the service of the Lord can all be worshipped.
那么就好像是任何一件衣服。任何一个床上用品，或者是主穿过的一双鞋，就是所有主用过的任何的物品，都是可以被崇拜的。
So the piece of cloth, that piece of outer cloth of Lord Chaitanya, this is just not different from Krishna himself, and it can be worshipped just like we would worship Krishna.
所以呢，所以 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 他所用过的这块布巾。和 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 是没有任何区别的，和 Krishna 没有任何区别的，所以呢，它是可以被崇拜的，就像崇拜主 Krishna 一样。
Just like Vrindavan, Vrindavan is also worshipable. It's a holy place of Krishna's pastimes, and we can worship the holy place just like we worship Krishna.
那么就好像 Sri Vrindavan Dham， 这 Vrindavan Dham 呢，因为它和 Sri Krishna 也没有任何的区别，因为它是 Sri Krishna 所上演逍遥时光的地方。所以呢，我们就可以像崇拜 Sri Krishna 那样崇拜 Sri Vrindavan Dham。
So we have to learn to worship everything which belongs to Krishna。
所以呢，我们必须要学着崇拜任何一件属于 Krishna 的东西。
Right, there's a famous verse Lord Shiva taught to his wife that he said that of all kinds of worship, the worship of Lord Vishnu is the best.
那就像有这么一个非常著名的诗节，是由主希瓦对他的妻子讲的。他说呢，在所有的这些崇拜中，对主威神的崇拜是最棒的。
But the worship of those things in relationship to Krishna is even better.
但是呢，崇拜那些与 Sri Krishna 相关联的那些事物就更好。
You can worship all of these things. So the king was worshipping this piece of cloth, just like Lord Chaitanya, just like it was Krishna himself. So then Ramananda Rai, he had come to stay with Lord Chaitanya, and he got permission from the king that he could do that. So the king also began to tell Ramananda Rai that you should help me to get to meet Lord Chaitanya. He told Ramananda, you get to meet Lord Chaitanya so many times, you should help me to get to meet Lord Chaitanya. So the king and Ramananda Rai, they came to Jagannath Puri, and Ramananda Rai went to meet Lord Chaitanya. So Ramananda Rai told Lord Chaitanya about the king, how he was such a nice devotee. So Ramananda Rai, he was a very intelligent person. He'd been the governor on behalf of the king in South India. So he knew how to do everything in the proper manner. He was very diplomatic. So just because Ramananda Rai was talking so nicely about Lord Chaitanya, Lord Chaitanya was becoming more and more impressed that this king is really a very great soul. Well, Lord Chaitanya had a few people who were his followers, who were very expert, who were very well trained in being diplomatic. Right, people like Sanatana Goswami and Rupa Goswami, they'd been big people in the government, so they had a very good background. They were very well trained in being diplomatic.
那就比如说像是Rupa Goswami，说了Sanatana Goswami，因为他们曾经都是政府的高官，所以呢，他们都是受过非常良好的训练，而且有很好的背景，而且呢，也都是非常的懂这种外交手段的。And
Raghunath Das also, Raghunath Das Goswami, when he was a young man, he was also born in a very wealthy family, and he was also very expert in diplomacy.
Goswami当他是一个年轻的时候，当他是个年轻人的时候呢，因为他是出生在一个非常富裕的家庭的，所以呢，他也懂外交这些方面的事情。We
see Sanatana Goswami at one point he was in jail, but he was so diplomatic and so expert he was able to get out of jail.
那我们知道 Sanatana Goswami 曾经有一段是被投入大狱的。 但就是由于他很圆滑的懂外交的这些处事的态度，他处事的方法，所以说呢，他就得以从监狱里面逃出来了。And
similarly, Raghunath Das was so expert. He one time, his father was in big trouble because some money had been taken in the wrong manner. So his father was going to get arrested and put in jail, but Raghunath was so expert, he was so good in talking, that he could save his father from the danger.
Raghunath Das Goswami 的父亲曾经呢，就是因为他的这个钱被坏人给拿走了，然后导致于他自己也遇到了这个灾祸，所以呢，差一点就要被投到大狱里面。但是呢 ，Raghunath Das Goswami 呢，就特别的有智慧的，特别的圆滑的，帮他的父亲解除了当时的那个灾祸。
So we see Srila Prabhupada also, he also needed people who were expert in diplomacy to be around him because he had to deal with many different important people. Yeah, if we cannot deal nicely with these important people, then we simply make enemies. We don't make any friends.
Because if we 要是没有很好的去应对这些重要人物的话，那么我们就有可能会和他们树敌，然后就变成了我们之间就变成敌人，而反而没有成为朋友。
No, when we are preaching, the results of our preaching should be that we make friends, not that we just make enemies.
所以说呢，我们传教的结果呢，应该是交到朋友，而不是竖起敌人。
We don't want to turn people away from Krishna consciousness. We want to attract them.
我们希望是把人吸引进 Krishna 知觉，而不是要把人从 Krishna 知觉中赶开。
Yeah, they should think, oh, the devotees of Krishna are so nice, they're such good people.
人们必须应该是这样想，觉得这些 Krishna 知觉的这些奉献者们都是这么好的人。
There was one television interview, Srila Prabhupada was in the USA, and Prabhupada was invited onto one television program, and the man interviewed him. And he asked him, he said, how would we be able to recognize these devotees of Krishna? Haribo? Danakili? Haribo? some problem with the internet here. I'm just waiting, trying to get connected. I don't know if I can get reconnected or not.